MILO Sports Clinic Online. Hi, I'm Coach Kenny Asuncion from the Asuncion Badminton Center for your beginner's badminton class. So, like I said in my previous video, we always have to start warming up. So, we'll start the warm up, we'll start with the feet. So again, rotate the feet in one direction, clockwise. After, switch to counterclockwise. And rotate your wrists as well. Switch leg, this time on the other side. And then reverse the rotation off the feet. Then change, okay? So this is how it looks from the front view, but when I move to the side, you will see my heel goes up and down. So foot goes up and down, the heel goes up and down. Front foot is flat on the floor. Switch sides, always remember to do both sides to even it out. So it doesn't matter if you're right-handed or you're left-handed, you have to warm up your entire body. Okay, change. Okay, move your feet sideways. This is in case when you're moving around and you suddenly do this movement, at least your feet is warmed up so you won't sprain your ankle or hurt your foot. Okay, so change this time. Rotation of the knee, inwards, outward, go up and down. You can do it longer and do it, I would normally do 10 counts, but if you want a little more or a little less, it's also fine. Okay, this time, push the hip to one side. Switch to the other side. This time, rotate your hips. Reverse. Okay, so now we're done with our feet, our knee, our hips. We move up to our arms. But there's no particular order. You can do this at another time in any order. So keep your elbows up. Move your upper body right and left. Keep your head facing forward and just moving the arms and the upper body. Change. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. Change. Arms are moving together. Both arms up. One arm up, but the other opposite arm is down and also moving. Okay, both arms up, down, side, down, up, down, side, down, up, down, side, down, up. Okay. So be as relaxed as possible. You are not doing the warm-up fast. You are warming up after all, so take your time to do the warm-up. Change, rotation. Reverse. This time, you rotate your elbow for the forearm, move and rotate it, and then switch the direction, and then we slowly rotate our head, slowly, I do not want to strain anything, do three rounds clockwise, then three rounds counterclockwise. Slowly, as relaxed as you can. Okay, so when you're done with the head, we'll move back to the whole body. Touch your toes. So opposite arm and foot. Left arm, right foot. Right hand, left foot. When you're done, do the lunge so you can step back your foot. Make sure your knee is above your ankle. Okay, back leg, stretch it to the back and bend your knee. Okay, so I'm just gonna move so you can see it from the side. This is how it looks. Switch leg. Keep your upper body high. Not bending down. Again, knee on top of the ankle. Okay, switch now. Go full down and stretch to one side. Keep your base foot flat. You can lean forward if you're using balance, or you can put your arm on the side. Okay, switch leg. Class. First is what I call 1-2-3. 1-2-3 is the basic way of hitting the shuttle. Second is footwork. We will be doing two kinds of footwork today. One is called V-front and the other one will be defense. So get your rackets and let's get started. So this drill is what I call 1-2-3. 1-2-3 is the basic way of hitting the shuttle. So we will start in our basic position with our racket up, feet as wide as your shoulders, and squat a little bit. Okay? When I say one, right leg and right hand goes to the back. But even my left arm is up. Okay, so there's a balance. You should feel like you're holding a box. Okay, so this one, and then two. My upper body turns forward to where I'm supposed to hit, and even my leg is turning, but it's still at the back. That's two. When I say three, arm and leg goes forward together. Again, let's do it one more time. Basic position, feet as wide as your shoulders. Make sure that you grip your racket correctly. One, two, three. Again, back to your basic position. One, two, three. I'm going to move to that direction so you can see it from that angle. Okay? So from here, that's going to be one, two, three. Okay? Back to your basic position again. Feet as wide as your shoulders. Racket is up. One, like a box, like you're carrying a box. Two, elbows up, close to your face. Three, swing forward. When you swing, make sure you hit at 11 o'clock. Not 12 o'clock, 11 o'clock. So again, you should hit the shuttle at 11 o'clock. Okay, hit the shuttle in front of you as high as you can. So once again, let's do the 1-2-3s. Back to your basic position. One, two, three. Basic position again. One, two, three. Now for our left-handed beginners, you can do the same thing, but of course, holding the racket with your left hand. Same stance, this is wide as your shoulders, but this time you move the left arm and the left leg together to the back. So from this position, we go one, two, elbows up, close to your face. Three, swing forward. When you swing forward, left leg and left arm goes forward together, but my arm is swinging to the opposite direction, so I don't end up hitting my leg. So again, I'll be facing there. Basic position, feet as wide as your shoulders. One, two, three. Again, back to your basic position. One, both arms up. Okay, so your upper arm should be clear on both sides. Okay, elbows are bent. One, two, three. Basic position. 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 One, two, three. Last one. Basic position. One, two, three. So there you have the 1-2-3 drill. You can practice this any time of the day. You can do it as long as you have the space. But for those that don't have the space, that you can't reach up with your racket, you can set your rackets aside. And just do the movement with your arms. So you can just put up your arms. One, two, three. One, two, three. Basic position. One, two, three. From the side. Basic position. One, two, three. Basic position. One, two, three. Basic position. One, two, three. So another way to practice the 1-2-3 drill is to get a shuttle, face the wall, and try to hit the shuttle to the wall with the 1-2-3 movement. Okay? So why do we put up our elbows close to our face? We are getting ready and we're targeting where we're about to hit the shuttle. Okay? So again, last time, basic position, 1-2-3. Basic position, 1-2-3. Basic position. 1-2-3. Basic position. 1-2-3. Basic position. 1-2-3. For the footwork, for our V front, it would be advisable to get a tape and scissors and use the tape put it to mark it on your, you know, your base. So this is my base. I'm going to stick some tape over here. And then I'm just going to walk 2 steps. 1, 2. And stick another tape here. Walk back. 2 steps. And stick one more tape. So that will be my marker. So I should always start on my base area. And then when I move out, I'm stepping on the tapes. We can start with a proper footwork. So again, our basic position is feet as wide as the shoulders. You have to squat a little bit and keep your racket up. Racket up means racket here in front of you. Okay, not above, not below. So racket up is here, just close to your face. So basic position, you only do 2 steps. If you are right-handed, you start in your left and end in your right. Come back, right, left. Again, left, right, right, left. Once more, left, right, left. On the left side, it's the same thing. You have to start with your left leg, left, right. End at the marker. Hit with a backhand. Back to the middle. Again, left, right. Back to the middle, right, left. When you go back to the middle, your feet is never close this way. There's always a space as wide as your shoulders, and you always squat a little bit with your racket up. So again, let's do it alternately, going to your forehand side, then going to the backhand side. Basic position, left, right hip, back to the middle. As soon as you end with your right leg, you hit, okay? Not big swings, just a small movement. Okay, so to the left side, left, right. middle, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left. You will notice that when I'm going in one direction, my feet, my toes start to point to the direction where I'm going. So in this case, if I put my left foot out, it's already pointing. And with the right, still pointing, hip. Okay, so wherever my feet is pointing is where my racket is supposed to be. Back to the middle. Same on the other side. It's left, right, pointing. Okay, we don't want to hurt our knees. We don't want our feet pointing here, but getting the shuttle here, or pointing here, but getting the shuttle far from our foot. So feet and arm goes together. Back to the middle. Again, let's do 10 counts. Alternately, right and left. Now, for the left-handed people, when you grip your racket with your left hand, it's just the opposite. So you start with your right and end with your left. So for example, I'm going to my forehand side for a backhanded person, left-handed person. So you start with your right, right, left, left, right. Again, it's right, left, left, right. On the other side, right, left, left, right, right, left, left, right. Okay? So, since I'm right-handed, I'll be doing it the right-handed way. If you're left-handed, just do the opposite. Okay? So start in your basic position. Let's do 10 counts. Left, right, back to the middle. Right, left, left, right, 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 right, left. Okay, so for those that don't have a racket yet, you can still do the drill. Set your rackets aside. And just do the footwork, just put your hands here in front of you, elbows slightly bent. One, two, reach up your arm, back to the middle. One, two, only two steps out, two steps back in. One, two. One, two. One, two. One, two. Our next lesson is the footwork called defense. Defense is going from side to side. So once again, it only entails two steps. You always start with your left and end with your right if you are right-handed. And for the left-handed, you start with your right and end with your left. So I will do the right-handed one first. So you start with your basic position. Use the marker that we used a while ago for the B-front. Okay, so that's your base, this is your middle. Okay, so moving to the forehand side, one step with your left, one, two. Look at my feet pointing to the side. Back to the middle, again, one more time, close, open the leg. Back to the middle, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left. Going on to the left side, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left. Upon ending with your right leg, you have to swing. No big swings. You do not want to swing from the back. You only swing from the side forward. So let's do it alternately. Right-handed people, right-handed beginners. Basic position, as wide as your shoulders. Squat a little, wrap it up. Left, right. Right, left, left, right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left. Now, for the left-handed people, start the basic position. Same, squat as wide, feet as wide as your shoulders. Squat a little bit, wrap it up. Start with your right leg, right, left. Left, right, again. Right, left, swing. Left, right, again. Right, left. Left, right. To the other side, right leg first, point. Left, swing. Back to the middle. Right, left. Back to the middle. Right, left. Back to the middle. One more time. Right, left. Okay? So let's do it alternately for 10 counts. Okay? I'm going to do the right-handed version. So if you are a left-handed beginner, just do the opposite leg, do the opposite arm. Okay? So, basic position. Left, right. Right, left. 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 Okay? So again, another reminder, another tip is to end and point your feet where you're taking the shuttle, where you're hitting the shuttle. Point. Okay? You cannot hit it this way because you're going to strain your knee. Point your feet where you're hitting. For those that do not have access to a racket, it's okay, it's fine. You can still do the footwork without the racket. So I'm setting my racket aside. Okay? And then we'll do the defense without the racket, but just swinging with our dominant hand. So if you're right-handed, swing with your right. If you're left-handed, then swing with your left. So basic position, left, right, back to the middle. 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 Left, right. Back to the middle. There you go. So that sums up our MILO Sports Clinic online for badminton beginners. This is brought to you by Asuncion Badminton Center and MILO.